Here's a great problem that at first looks just like a typical find the volume problem, but it's going to be the return of trig. So good old SOHCAHTOA is coming back for this problem to help us find the volume of this. So as we've done with volume volume before for a cone, we need to know two things. We need to know the area of the base, and I need to know the height of the cone. Because the formula to find the volume of a cone or a pyramid is area of the base times the height, and then divide by 3. So I'm going to need to know the area of the base and the height. The height's given to me. The height is the straight up and down distance from the top of the cone to the base. So that height is just 16 that was given to me. But to find B, the area of the base, I need to find the area of the circle. And as you can see, that circle's radius is unknown to me. So I don't. That's what I need to find. This is where trigonometry is going to come into play. So what I want to do is I want to just look at that right triangle. So the right triangle formed between the height, the slant height, and the radius. They give me one angle, and that's the 65 degrees. So let's go ahead and use trig. Hopefully we remember some things about it. Otherwise, go back and watch a trig video to see if we can find that radius. So using this as the angle they give me, I'm going to identify my sides. The 16 must be the opposite side. And then the radius is the side I want to find. That's going to be the adjacent side, the side next to this. So looking at SOHCAHTOA, the part of SOHCAHTOA that uses O and A is going to be the tangent. So I'm going to be using tangent this time to find my radius. So let's write our trig equation. We have this side work to do before we can go back and find the volume. So the tangent of 65 needs to be equal to the opposite side, which is 16, over the adjacent side, which is the radius I'm trying to find. When I showed you guys this way back when, I like to do this as a proportion, so I'm going to put that over 1. Using a calculator to find the tangent of 65, and then cross-multiplying that, I'm going to end up with about 2.1445, I like to do 4 decimal places when I'm working with trig stuff, times the radius, and then equals, when I cross-multiply the other way, 16. Dividing both sides by 2.1445, the radius comes out to be approximately 7.46. So that's my radius of the cone. Knowing that number, I can now go back and finish this problem to find the area of the base. So since my base was a circle, I'm going to do pi, about 3.14, times the radius squared. Using a calculator, I get a base area of about 174.75. So let's go ahead and get that plugged in our blank up here, 174.75. And finally, I now have all the information I need to finish this problem. Let's use a calculator to do the area of the base, 174.75, times the height, which was 16 that was given to me, and then divide by 3, because we're dealing with an object that comes to a point. We always have to divide by 3 for the volume. Reaching for a calculator and finishing that out, I get 932 and include a good label. Volume is always measured in cubic feet, or cubic units, so in this case, cubic feet. So there is going to be my volume using trigonometry to help me find some missing information.